Is this mic working? So, anyways, I decided to get my Rook piercing, like re-pierced it again. And I am glad to share you my experience, my healing process, and my piercing aftercare, and also the pain scale level of my Rook throughout this video. If you are interested, keep on watching.
Shut the fuck up, no one cares. Money go long like Nia. I am the big
idea. My twins big like Tia. My twins big like Tia. For anything else, if you don't know what a Rook piercing is a type of cartilage piercing that is pierced right over here on the upper inner corners of the cartilage, right over the ridge, the inner ridge. So it is usually pierced with a 16 gauge needle. The type of barbell that is used for this piercing is usually a curved barbell. Not everyone can get this type of piercing. It still depends on their ear structure or the ear anatomy. And for me, this is one of the most easiest to take care of. But of course, beware of the rejection, and it should be pierced in the right spot, unlike what happened to me last time. So speaking of last time, if you ever remember my last piercing video, my piercing tour video, I discussed there about my Rook piercing rejection. So I got my Rook piercing last year, and I noticed right away that it was too shallow and it was pierced in the wrong spot. So if in that case, there is a high percentage or high possibility of your piercing getting rejected, which later on happened to me. So it's been months and I noticed that my Rook piercing is moving towards the edge of my ear. So in that case, I decided to get rid of the piercing immediately because it will leave a huge scar in my ear if I did not take it off right away. It's not been weeks, but rather months before I take it out so that it won't get infected. I am really devoted in cleaning it, so it does not have any infection, or it's not getting red, but rather you can really see the bar of the piercing through the ear. If you look at my Rook, you can still see the line or the scar where it used to be. Anyways, if you haven't watched the video, feel free to click right here. You don't want to miss out this piercing journey. The reason that I got it re-pierced is I really, really like how the Rook piercing or the Rook jewelry sits right into my ear. And I'm 100% sure that this kind of ear structure is built for a Rook piercing. You can see right over here that my ridge is really prominent for me. And yeah, I'm really confident that I should get this re-pierced somehow. So, I go back to my original piercer, the one who pierced my helix piercing, right over here. I did not have any problems within the healing process. It's been really going well. So, I contact my piercer right away and I book a schedule because I am really determined to get it re-pierced. So, anyways, I'm not going to make this any longer, and here is the process of my Rook piercing getting pierced. Nandito na ako ngayon sa piercer ko, and I'm gonna get my Rook re-pierced. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, you wanna pump my speakers? 3, 2, 3, better blow your mama's teeth out at you. Like I'm Pika, then I spit like I'm Nino. Wish you Merry Christmas, set fire to my sneakers. 1, 2, 3, 4, might need some anesthesia. See me in the bleacher, but I cut up like a Anita. You like paprika, then I wanna spit like a Rita. You see me, you feel me, you got me, Eureka. What you want? Everybody know what they want. What you want? Say, who's talking bad? Some trousers and a black eye. 3, 2, 3, only say what's up for the Wi-Fi. Cause I'm supposed to be grown. This how I feel, bone to bone. And I did post, but I'm alone. Rich off catfish like Petco. Damn right, she stole that Bacardi. Damn right, he drive fake Ferrari. God damn it, ain't even a party without you flexing that Murakami. Always late to the best. Showtime never ends. So fast forward up to this day, this is my Rook piercing. It's been sitting there for almost a month or probably 3 weeks from now, from where it pierced. So far, it's been healing well, it's been doing good, it does not have any infection or complications at all. I really like how this piercing sits in my ear because it has been protected by my forward helix right over here, which makes the healing process really, really easier. Also, another thing that I really like about this piercing is that it is not easily getting tugged by my hair or anything else because it is in the inner part of the cartilage and it is protected by the helix, the forward helix, like I mentioned. Now let's talk about the pain level scale. Okay, so on the scale of 1 to 10, 1 is the lowest and 10 is the highest. Okay, so at this part of the piercing process, this is where everyone has been wondering, what is the pain or what is the feeling? As you can see at the video, I actually discussed in the video that it has been pierced twice. So at the first piercing trial, they pierced it from the bottom to the top. But unfortunately, the needle did not go through the top. It is almost on the top, but they lose the hole. So that did not go well at all. I only felt pressure right through my ear. It did not hurt at all. But since the hole is already probably closed at that time and they can't find it, they decided to re-pierce it again for the second time. Okay. So the first trial, I only felt 2 on the pain scale level, but girl, the best friend, that 2 went up to 5, like freaking 5, you guys. You know what they say, the second piercing hurts more than the first piercing is because probably your brain is already aware of the trauma or let's say the process, the pain that you experienced for the first piercing. And you're already aware of it, that you are going to poke a needle right through your ear. So probably that hurts a lot. At this time, they did is from the top to the bottom. And yeah, that go through. But unfortunately, it bled very, very badly. I wasn't prepared, best friend. Oh yeah, here's an additional tip. If ever you're getting pierced and you're really scared, always remember to breathe. Don't hold your breath when you're getting a piercing because you might pass out. That's why when the piercer is like getting you pierced, you have to breathe in and then you have to breathe out so that you can easily, let's say, divert your attention throughout the piercing and you won't pass out. I've experienced that. I almost passed out at some point because I hold my breath. Don't be nervous and just keep calm whenever you're getting a piercing. I know that everyone has a different pain level tolerance and yeah, it still depends on you. Okay, so the most important part of this video is the aftercare. This piercing barely hurts at all in the healing process, which is very good and it's been doing really well. Okay, so like any basic piercing aftercare, I use a sea salt soak solution that I did, which is composed of a cup of water, a warm water preferably, and a tablespoon of sea salt. And then you will mix it and you will soak your ear or your freshly piercing there for about 5 minutes or more. But preferably it is 5 minutes. But before this, if you notice any crusties or build up in your ears, make sure you use a Q-tip and clean it with that. Soak your Q-tip in the sea salt solution and use that to clean the crusties all over your ear. So remember that those crusties are a part of the healing process and it is not a sign of infection. Also, make sure that you clean your piercing twice a day, every morning and every night, so that you can sanitize it and prevent it from any infections. So the last thing I do after I soak it in a sea salt solution, okay, so this is an additional step, and this product really helps a lot in healing my piercings because it speeds up the healing process. So to top it all off, I spray my fresh new piercing with a colloidal silver spray to secure my newly pierced ears and prevent it from any infections, and also, like I mentioned, to heal the wound faster. Okay, if you're interested in purchasing this Collider Silver product, make sure to check down the description box below and I will leave a link there. I recommend to use a neck pillow or a travel pillow whenever you have a new piercing. Be mindful that you should take care and avoid your piercing getting irritated, especially when you are sleeping and you keep switching positions and like laying down your side. So this travel pillow, as you can see right over here, has a hole in the middle and you can like put your ear inside the hole so you can sleep on sideways. So at that point, you can protect your ears from getting rubbed on the pillows and you can sleep peacefully as well. Always check your piercing for any infections or sign of rejection and be mindful of that, okay? And of course, don't forget to follow me on my social media at Alien Trash to receive more updates about this piercing. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a great day. Keep safe. I hope everything goes well. Like really well in this pandemic. So it's been a year, you know. So I'll see you guys in my next video whenever I have one. So paalam!